chemical coordination and integration. You've already learned that the neural system provides a point-to-point rapid coordination among organs. The neural coordination is fast but short-lived, as the nerve fibers do not innervate all cells in the body, and the cellular function need to be continuously regulated. A special kind of coordination and integration has to be provided. This function is carried out by hormones. The neural system and the endocrine system jointly coordinate and regulate the physiological function in the body, endocrine glands and the hormones. Endocrine glands lack ducts and are hence called ductless glands. Their secretion are called hormones. The classical definition of hormone as a chemical produced by endocrine glands and released into the blood and transported to a distantly located target organ has current scientific definition as follows. Hormones are non-nutrient chemicals which act as intercellular messengers and are produced in a trace membrane. The new definition covers a number of new molecules in addition to the hormones secreted by organized endocrine glands. Invertebrates possesses very simple endocrine system with a few hormones, whereas a large number of chemicals act as hormones and provide coordination in the vertebrates. The human endocrine system is described here. Human endocrine system. The endocrine glands and hormones producing diffused tissues or cells located in different parts of our body constitute the endocrine system. Pituitary, pineal, thyroid, adrenal, pancreas, parathyroid, thymus and gonads, that is testes in males and ovaries in females, are the organized endocrine bodies in our body. In addition to these, some other organs, example gastrointestinal tract, liver, kidney, heart also produces hormone. A brief account of the structure and functions of all major endocrine glands and hypothalamus of the human body is given in the following section. The hypothalamus. As you know, the hypothalamus is the basal part of diencephalon fodder, and it regulates a wide spectrum of body function. Contains several groups of neurosecretory cells called nuclei, which produce hormones. These hormones regulate the synthesis and secretion of pituitary hormones. However, the hormones produced by hypothalamus are of two types: the releasing hormone, which stimulates secretion of pituitary hormones, and the inhibiting hormone, which inhibits secretion of pituitary hormones. For example, a hypothalamic hormone called gonadotropin releasing hormone stimulates the pituitary synthesis and release the gonadotropins. On the other hand, somatostatin from the hypothalamus inhibits the release of growth hormone from the pituitary. These hormones originating in the hypothalamic neuron pass through axons and are released from their nerve ending. These hormones release the pituitary gland through a portal circulatory system and regulate the function of anterior pituitary. And posterior pituitary is under direct neural regulation of hypothalamus. The pituitary gland. The pituitary gland is located on a bony cavity called a cella turcica and is attached to hypothalamus by a stalk. It is divided anatomically into an adenohypophysis and a neurohypophysis. Adenohypophysis consists of two portions, pars distalis and pars intermedia. The pars distalis region of pituitary, commonly called anterior pituitary, produces growth hormone, prolactin, thyroid stimulating hormone, adrenocorticotrophic hormone, luteinizing hormone, and follicle stimulating hormone. Pars intermedia secretes only one hormone called melanocyte stimulating hormone. However, in humans, the pars intermedia is almost merged with the pars distalis. Neurohypophysis, that is pars nervosa, also known as posterior pituitary, stores and releases two hormones called oxytocin and vasopressin, which are actually synthesized by hypothalamus and are transported axonally to neurohypophysis. Over secretion of growth hormone stimulates abnormal growth of the body, leading to gigantism, and lower secretion of growth hormone results in stunted growth, resulting in pituitary dwarfism. Prolactin regulates the growth of mammary gland and formation of milk in them. Thyroid stimulating hormone stimulates the synthesis and secretion of thyroid hormone from the thyroid gland. Adenocorticotrophic hormone stimulates the synthesis and secretion of steroid hormone called glucocorticoids from the adrenal cortex. Luteinizing hormone and the follicular stimulating hormone stimulates gonadal activity and hence are called gonadotrophins. In males, luteinizing hormone stimulates the synthesis and secretion of hormone called androgen from testes. In female, follicular stimulating hormone. In males, follicular stimulating hormone and androgen regulate spermatogenesis. In females, luteinizing hormone induces ovulation of fully matured follicles, that is graafing follicles, and maintains the corpus luteum formed from the remnants of the graafing follicle after ovulation. Follicular stimulating hormone stimulates growth and development of ovarian follicles in females. Melanocyte stimulating hormone acts on the melanocytes, that is melanin containing cells, and regulates pigmentation of the skin. Oxytocin acts on the smooth muscles of our body and stimulates their contraction. In females, it stimulates a vigorous contraction of the uterus at the time of childbirth and milk ejection from the mammary gland. Vasopressin acts mainly at the kidney and stimulates reabsorption of water and electrolyte from distal tubules and thereby reduces loss of water through urine, that is diuresis. Hence, it is also called diuretic hormone, ADH. The pineal gland is located on dorsal side of forebrain. Pineal secretes a hormone called melatonin. Melatonin plays a very important role in regulation of a 24-hour diurnal rhythm of our body. For example, it helps in maintaining the normal rhythm of a sleep-wake cycle. Body temperature, in addition, melatonin also influences metabolism, pigmentation and menstrual cycle as well as our defense capability. Thyroid hormone. The thyroid gland is composed of two lobes which are located on either side of the trachea. Both the lobes are interconnected with a thin flap of connective tissues called isthmus. The thyroid gland is composed of follicles and stromal tissues. Each thyroid follicle is composed of follicular cells enclosing a cavity. These follicular cells synthesize two hormones, tetraiodothyroxine, that is T4, and triiodothyroxine, T3, iodine. Iodine is essential for the normal rate of hormone synthesis in the thyroid. Deficiency of iodine in our diet results in hypothyroidism and enlargement of thyroid gland. Commonly called goiter. Hypothyroidism during pregnancy causes defective development and maturation of growing baby, leading to stunted growth, that is cretinism, mental retardation, low intelligence quotient, abnormal skin, deaf, that is mutism, etc. In adult women, hypothyroidism may cause menstrual cycle to become irregular due to cancer of thyroid gland or due to development of nodules of the thyroid gland. The rate of synthesis and secretion of thyroid hormone is increased to abnormal high level, leading to condition called hyperthyroidism, which adversely affects the body physiology. Thyroid hormones play an important role in regulation of the basal metabolic rate. These hormones also support the process of red blood cell formation. Thyroid hormones control the metabolism of carbohydrate, protein and fats. Maintenance of water and electrolyte balance is also influenced by thyroid hormones. Thyroid glands also secretes a protein hormone called thyrocalcitonin, TCT, which regulates the blood calcium level. Parathyroid gland. In humans, four parathyroid glands are present in backside of the thyroid gland. Each in the two lobes of the thyroid glands. The parathyroid glands secrete a peptide hormone called parathyroid hormone. The secretion of parathyroid hormone is regulated by circulating level of calcium ions. Parathyroid hormone increases the calcium level in the blood. Parathyroid hormone acts on bones and stimulates the process of bone resorption, that is dissolution or demineralization. Parathyroid hormone also stimulates reabsorption of calcium by the renal tubules and increases calcium absorption from digested food. It is thus clear that parathyroid hormone is a hypercalcemic hormone, that is it increases the blood calcium level along with thyroid calcitonin. It plays a significant role in calcium balance in the body. Thymus. The thymus gland is a lobular structure located between lungs behind the sternum on the ventral side of aorta. The thymus plays a major role in the development of immune system. This gland secretes the peptide hormone called thymosins. Thymosins play a major role in the differentiation of T lymphocytes, which provide cell-mediated immunity. In addition, thymosin also promotes production of antibiotics to provide hormonal immunity. Thus, thymus is degenerated in old individuals, resulting in decreased production of thymosin. As a result, the immune response of old persons become weak. Adrenal gland. Our body has one pair of adrenal glands, one at the anterior part of each kidney. The gland is composed of two types of tissue. The centrally located tissue is called the adrenal medulla, and outside this lies the adrenal cortex. The adrenal medulla secretes two hormones called adrenaline or epinephrine and noradrenaline or norepinephrine. These are commonly called as catecholamines. Adrenaline and noradrenaline are rapidly secreted in response to stress or stress of any kind and during emergency situation, and are called emergency hormones or hormones of fight or flight. These hormones increases alertness, pupillary dilation, piloerection, that is a raising of hats, sweating, etc. Both the hormones increases the heartbeat, the strength of heart contraction and the rate of respiration. Catecholamines also stimulate the breakdown of glycogen, resulting in an increased concentration of glucose in blood. In addition, they also stimulate the breakdown of lipids and proteins. The adrenal cortex can be divided into three layers called zona reticularis, inner layer, zona fascicularis, that is a middle layer, and zona glomerulus, that is outer layer. The adrenal cortex secretes many hormones commonly called corticoids. The corticoids which are involved in carbohydrate metabolism are called glucocorticoids. In our body, cortisol is the main glucocorticoid. Corticoids which regulate the balance of water and electrolytes in our body are called mineralocorticoids. Aldosterone is the main mineralocorticoid in our body. Glucocorticoid stimulates gluconeogenesis, lipolysis and proteolysis and inhibits cellular uptake and utilization of amino acids. Cortisol is also involved in maintaining the cardiovascular system as well as kidney functions. Glucocorticoids, particularly cortisol, provide anti-inflammatory reactions and suppress the immune response. Cortisol stimulates the RBC production. Aldosterone acts mainly at the renal tubules and stimulates the reabsorption of Na plus and water and excretion of K plus and phosphate ions. Thus, aldosterone helps in the maintenance of electrolytes, body fluid volume, osmotic pressure and blood pressure. Small amounts of androgenic steroid are also secreted by adrenal cortex, which plays a role in the growth of axillary hair, pubic hair and facial hair during puberty. Pancreas. Pancreas is the composite gland which acts as both the exocrine and endocrine gland. The endocrine pancreas consists of islets of Langerhans. These are about 1 to 2 million islets of Langerhans in a normal human pancreas, representing only 1 to 2% of the pancreatic tissue. The two main types of cells in the islets of Langerhans are called alpha cells and beta cells. The alpha cell secretes a hormone called glucagon, while the beta cell secretes insulin. Glucagon is a peptide hormone and plays an important role in maintaining the normal blood glucose level. Glucagon acts mainly on the liver cells, hepatic cells, hepatocytes, and stimulates glycogenolysis, resulting in an increased blood sugar, hyperglycemia. In addition, this hormone stimulates the process of gluconeogenesis, which also contributes to hyperglycemia. Glucagon reduces the cellular glucose uptake and utilization. Thus, glucagon is a hyperglycemic hormone. Insulin is a peptide hormone which plays a major role in the regulation of glucose homeostasis. Insulin acts mainly on hepatocytes and adipocytes, cells of adipose tissue, and enhances cellular glucose uptake and utilization. As a result, there is a rapid movement of glucose from blood to hepatocytes and the adipocytes, resulting in increased blood glucose level, that is hypoglycemia. Insulin also secretes conversion of glucose to oxygen, gluconeogenesis, in the target cells. The glucose homeostasis in blood is thus maintained jointly by the two, insulin and glucagon. Prolonged hyperglycemia leads to a complex disorder called diabetes mellitus, which is associated with the loss of glucose through urine and formation of harmful compounds known as ketone bodies. Diabetic patients are successfully treated with insulin therapy. Testis. A pair of testes is present in a scrotal sac outside abdomen of the male individuals. Testis performs dual function as a primary sex organ as well as an endocrine gland. Testis is composed of seminiferous tubules and stromal or interstitial tissues. The Leydig cells and interstitial cells, which are present in the intertubular spaces, produce a group of hormones called androgens, mainly testosterone. Androgens regulate the development, maturation, and function of male accessory sex organs like epididymis, vas deferens, and seminal vesicle, prostate gland, urethra, etc. These hormones stimulate the muscular growth of facial and axillary hair, aggressiveness, low pitch of the voice, etc. Androgen plays a major stimulatory role in process of spermatogenesis, formation of sperm reservoir. Androgens act on the central neural system and influence the male sex behavior, libido. These hormones produce anabolic, that is synthetic effect on protein and carbohydrates metabolism. Ovary. Females have pair of ovaries located in abdomen. Ovary is the primary female sex organ, which produce one ovum during each menstrual cycle. In addition, ovary also produce two groups of steroid hormones called estrogen and progesterone. Ovary is composed of ovarian follicles and stromal tissues. The estrogen is synthesized and secreted mainly by the growing ovarian follicles. After ovulation, the ruptured follicle is converted to a structure called corpus luteum, which secretes mainly progesterone. Estrogen produces wide-range actions such as stimulations of growth and activities of a female secondary sex organ. Development of growing ovarian follicle, appearance of a female secondary sex character, that is high-pitched voice, etc. Mammalian gland development. Estrogen also regulates female sexual behavior. Progesterone supports pregnancy. Progesterone also acts on the mammary gland and stimulates the formulation of alveoli, sac-like structure which stores milk and milk secretion. Hormones of heart, kidney, and gastrointestinal tract. Now you know about the endocrine glands and their hormones. However, as mentioned earlier, hormones are also secreted by some tissues which are not endocrine glands. For example, the atrial wall of our heart secretes a very important peptide hormone called atrial narcotic factor, ANF, which decreases the blood pressure when blood pressure is increased. ANF is secreted, which causes dilation of blood vessels, which reduce blood pressure. The juxtamedullary cells of kidney produces a peptide hormone called erythropoietin, which stimulates erythropoiesis, formation of RBCs. endocrine cells present in a different part of gastrointestinal tract secrete four major peptide hormones, namely gastrin, secretin, cholecystokinin, CCK, and the gastric inhibitory peptide, GPA. Gastrin acts on gastric glands and stimulates the secretion of HCL and pepsinogen. Secretin acts on the exocrine pancreas and stimulates the secretion of water and bicarbonate ion. CCK acts on both pancreas and gallbladder and stimulates the secretion of pancreatic acid and bile juice, respectively. GPA inhibits gastric secretion and motility. Several other non-endocrine tissues secrete hormones called growth factor. These factors are essential for the normal growth of tissue and their repairing or regeneration. Mechanism of hormone action. Hormone produces their effects on target tissues by binding to specific protein called hormone receptors located in the target tissues. Only hormone receptor present on the cell membrane of the target cells are called membrane-bound receptors, and the receptors present inside the target cells are called intracellular receptors. Mostly, nuclear receptors present in the nucleus, binding of a hormone to its receptor leads to the formation of a hormone receptor complex. Each receptor is specific to one hormone only, and hence receptor of specific hormone receptor complex formation leads to certain biochemical changes in the target tissue. Target tissue metabolism and hence physiological function are regulated by hormones. On the basis of their chemical nature, hormones can be divided into groups. That is, number one, peptic, polypeptide, and protein hormones, example, insulin, glucagon, pituitary hormone, hypothalamic hormones, etc. Second, steroids, example, cortisol, testosterone, estradiol, and progesterone. Third, thyroid hormones. That is, fourth, amino acid derivatives, example, epinephrine. Hormones which interact with membrane-bound receptors normally do not enter the target cell, but generate secondary messages, example, cyclic AMP and IP3 and calcium, etc., which in turn regulates cellular metabolism. Hormone which interacts with the intercellular receptors, example, steroid hormones or iodothyronines and etc., mostly regulate gene expression or chromosomal functions by the interaction of hormone receptor complex with genome. Cumulative biochemical action results in physiological and development effects.